insulin resistance explained. By the end of this video, you're going to understand the two primary theories behind insulin resistance and how to use this information to lose weight and improve your health.
Hit the subscribe button to improve your fitness, health, and nutrition.
Okay, let's talk about insulin resistance. First, we'll talk about what insulin is. Then we'll go over why you don't want to be insulin resistant. And then we'll go over the two theories behind insulin resistance. And then stick around to the end of the video because I'm going to give you some diet recommendations on how to prevent or hopefully even reverse insulin resistance. So what is insulin? Insulin is the storage hormone. It's produced from the pancreas within your body to control blood sugar. That would be the basic explanation. Look at it as a storage hormone. But besides storing away carbohydrates, it also can store away fats. It can also enhance protein synthesis. So whenever you're in a fed state, whenever you're eating food, insulin is actually increased by the pancreas to store away any excess calories that you're not burning right at that time. So you're pretty much in a fed state. Like the inverse, the opposite hormone of insulin is actually glucagon. So for example, when there's not enough sugar within the blood, glucagon will help release sugar glucose into the bloodstream. Now the body doesn't like more than about 5 grams of sugar within the blood at any one time. It's only a teaspoon, not much. For example, if you ever gone to the doctor and you look at your fasted glucose levels and you know, they want you below like 105 or want you below 106. So 100 is pretty much about 5 grams, just like exactly 1 teaspoon of sugar within the blood. Like if you're 200, unfortunately, you're diabetic. So you see, it's a very delicate balance. Now, doctors, physicians don't want you above 106. So for example, if you start creeping up, insulin kicks in and supposed to be able to take this blood sugar out of the blood and store it away in your muscles and in your liver in the form of glycogen. Okay, so that's the primary purpose of insulin. Just view it in your mind as the storage hormone. All excess calories are going to be stored away with the help of insulin. Okay, now what happens when you get insulin resistance? It just means that you're unable in a way to store away these excess calories. Okay, and there's two theories behind how insulin resistance actually works. Let's go over theory number one. Okay, theory number one is pretty much, they call it like the lock and key theory. Like look at insulin as being the key to open up cells to store away excess calories. Okay, look at it like this. Okay, you ate a big carbohydrate meal. Like, so let's say you had a big bowl of pasta, you had some bread. Okay, now this pasta is broken down in the digestive system and sugar is released, glucose is released into the bloodstream. Now, obviously, if you're not burning all those carbohydrates right then, like we said earlier, the bloodstream doesn't like more than about 5 grams of sugar in it. So those excess carbohydrates want to get stored away in your muscles and in your liver in the form of glycogen. Okay. Now the pancreas starts pumping out this insulin to open up the door to unlock those cells to store away these excess calories. But the first theory on insulin resistance is that if you're chronically overeating and you're eating tons and tons of carbohydrates, you're overweight over time, over weeks, months, and actually years, your cells become resistant to the insulin. That means the pancreas is still pumping out the insulin, but the muscle cells are just not responding to it. So the liver is not responding to it. So then what happens to these excess calories? They can be converted into fat, into triglycerides, and the liver can make triglycerides out of these excess carbohydrates. You can get fatty liver disease, you know, just a lot of bad metabolic type diseases like type 2 diabetes can happen when you're resistant to insulin. So that's one theory. Now let's talk about the other theory. Now I learned about this other theory from Dr. Jason Fong. You know, he's an expert on diabetes, fasting, and you know, weight control. He feels that it's not necessarily that the cells are resistant to insulin. He just feels that the cells are full. Okay, this is what we mean. Like for example, when you're eating these carbohydrates, depending about how big you are, you can only store so many of them away For example, say the average person, like someone my size, 160 pounds or so, say I can store 2,000 calories of excess carbohydrates in the form of glycogen in my muscles. Like maybe a big guy, 250 pounds, maybe he can store 3,000 calories, okay? And your liver, the average liver, you know, maybe 200 to 400 calories of glycogen to be stored in the liver, so not too much. And so his theory is that it's not that the cells are not responding to the insulin. He just thinks that everything is full. Even your fat, like we said earlier, insulin also helps you store away fat, helps you, you know, synthesize protein. So he feels that if your fat cells are full with lipids, with fat, if your muscle cells are full with glycogen, if your liver is just full with glycogen, there's no place for these excess calories to go. And that's how you get fatty liver disease. That's how you want it with type 2 diabetes. That's how you're increasing your visceral fat, all the horrible negative things that come from excess calories. So actually, like, fat, and somehow, like, actually storing more fat is somewhat protective. But the theory number two says that it's not that the key doesn't fit. It's just that everything is full. And it's really interesting. You know, I always believe in the first theory of insulin resistance as opposed to the second theory, but I think I believe in the second theory as well. It's in my personal opinion, actually, I'm not a doctor. I'm not even a nutritionist. You know, I'm a fitness trainer. I've been training clients for 30 years. I read tons of these studies, really enjoy studying all this stuff. But I think it's a combination of both, of the cells not necessarily responding to the insulin if it's chronically high all the time. And then also when your muscles and liver and fat cells are just full to the max, there's no place for these excess calories to go. Okay, now, you know, sorry to paint such a negative scenario. So what do you do? Obviously, you got to reduce your calories. That's a great way to prevent or even possibly reverse insulin resistance. Fasting, intermittent fasting, time-restricted eating. I'm going to link up a whole bunch of videos I did on that topic. That's a great way to actually help either prevent or reverse, possibly reverse insulin resistance. The whole key is that you can't eat in excess, unfortunately. You don't want your muscle cells and your liver to just be full to the max with carbohydrates. You don't want your fat cells to just be full with fat. You know, just unfortunately, this is so preventable with just normal lifestyle modification. Okay, now I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did like the video, make sure you give me a thumbs up, you know, hit that bell indicator, and let me know what you think. Do you believe in theory number one, theory number two when it comes to insulin resistance, or do you feel like it's a combination of both like I do? Okay, well, take care everyone and have a wonderful day.